Hello, hello, my sunshines. Welcome back. As you can tell from the intro, this video is going to be just a little bit different. Obviously, I'm not home. And as a side note, why is there always a bed in the background of my videos? The world may never know. But I'm going to share where I am and how I got here over the next couple of days. And I thought it might just be fun to take you guys along with me. Now, keep in mind, I'm not a vlogger. I'm a girl who sits in front of the camera and opens things and shares hauls with you. So this vlog is probably going to be a little bit rough because it's not typically what I do, but I thought it would be fun to just mix it up. So we're going to rewind about a month ago, and Wantable reached out to me. I love Wantable, you guys know that, and said, hey, we're celebrating our 10th anniversary at our home office, and we would love for you to come out and celebrate with us. Well, of course, I jumped at the opportunity. I have to tell you, I don't think I've ever shared this with anybody before, but when I started YouTube, you know, you have business goals, but I also had like fun goals. And one of my fun goals was to be able to go on a trip with a brand. So when they reached out, I was over the moon. And so tomorrow night, there's going to be a big party at the Wantable headquarters. But this morning, I flew into Milwaukee. I've never been here before, and it is so beautiful. On the plane, they said Milwaukee is 69 degrees. And I was like, I love Milwaukee because I left like 95. It's just a beautiful day here. So I went ahead and flew in, and then I went over to the Wantable headquarters. They have the coolest like Wantable cafe. It's open to the public from what I understand. And it's like a really cool workspace and you can get lunch there. But they had a little event for just three or four of us. It was supposed to be just for the influencers who are in the area. I think there's three of us that are flying in from long distance, but my plane got in early. So they said, hey, do you want to come have lunch with us too? So I said, yes. I have this little dress on from the Loft. It's kind of floral. I thought it gave like ladies who lunch type vibes. It's hard for me because I don't have the mentality of vlogging everything, and we were meeting so many people. So I will try and be better about showing some of the behind the scenes stuff. But when we were there, there was little goodie bags at our place. And oh my gosh, you guys, I don't think they know that I love stars, but they're stars on the tissue paper. So we got this really cool candelier bag, and it's got a candle and an essential oil and this really cool bracelet. I feel like it's so my brand. Look at this bracelet, hold on. It says, girl, spread the love, and it says good vibes. Isn't that adorable? And then we got a Wantable t-shirt. And what I love about this Wantable t-shirt is it has Milwaukee on the bottom. Really, really cool. This is from one of Wantable's private brands called 78 and Sunny. And then I got a little bucket hat that says Hustle, which is really, really cute too. So that was my little goodie today. I had a Cobb salad, and then they had, oh my gosh, I just realized I'm missing something. Oh no, they're in the bottom here. They had this whole platter of like my absolute favorite cookies. Well, I love shortbread cookies, but macarons. These are macarons, not macaroons. Macarons, and I took two. They said I could, so I could eat them at the hotel tonight. So I'm staying at this really cool hotel. Wantable set it up for me. It's called the Kin Guest House Downtown. And I'll take you through a little room tour if you're interested. It's really, really cool because they have it set up like family style. So the thought behind it is you can be in your room, but then you can go outside and there's all these like individual rooms. Like right outside my room is a room with a fireplace and two chairs. So they want you to like get to know the people on your floor. There's this big, huge, like butcher block bar. Actually, it might not be butcher block, but this big huge bar out there, and there's fridges and all kinds of things. There's games. So if you just want to have a quiet night in, you can do that and hang out. I love the concept of this because I was thinking as a mama when my kids were little, every once in a while when we go to a hotel, like one of them will wake up in the middle of the night. We couldn't get them back to sleep. So it would be nice to have that outside area that we could go and like hang out for a little while. I mean, quietly, because we wouldn't have wanted to disturb the other people. But anyway, I thought I would just give you a little room tour and show you where I'm staying.
Okay, so when you walk in the door here, this is kind of what the entryway looks like. There's just a wall. Then you walk into the bathroom. This is my straightening iron and my steamer. I had to steam this dress, kind of see my outfit. I wore a little jeans jacket with it, and then my little Tory Burch flats. But the steamer is from Amazon. I love it so much that I bought one for Dawson for when he went away to school. I'll link it down below because it's really inexpensive and it's so good. So here's the bathroom, that big glassed-in shower. And then, I don't know if you care about the toilet, but there it is. I like that there's some hooks on the wall too, because when I was steaming my dress, I was able to just hang it right there. And then here's the door that we came back in. And then they have this whole built out like bookshelf area, this little nook. You've got a place to put your shoes on, luggage rack, some shelving. Sorry, the lighting is not the best in here. I'm doing the best I can with what I have. And then there's a huge mirror so you can check your outfit before you leave. And then you come in and there's just a standard, you know, nightstands and bed. It says, maybe you're right. I need that blown up and put on my husband's side of the bed. I love that picture. Then we have a window, a little nook, which actually I set hair in red just a little bit before I went to lunch. Here's our little desk with my Wantable items. I did have to go to CVS and pick up a couple things that I forgot. And then there's my denim jacket that I wore to the lunch. And then my suitcase. And look at this cute picture. How funny is that? I'll take some video outside in a minute when nobody's out there. I heard some talking. I don't want anybody to feel uncomfortable, but I'll kind of show you the concept of the outside too. Okay, so when you come out my door, they have this really cute little room here with some chairs, a big table. If you want to come out and eat dinner. Really cute art on the wall, and then they have this like fireplace setup. I assume that's what that is. And then there's a big TV overhead. I don't want to make you guys sick, so I'm gonna go slow here. I love the light fixture above this table. Isn't it so cute? And then you come out here and the elevator is out here, right here. And then you've got this big like section. They have pastries and stuff in the morning. Every floor has one of these. And then you've got this. And then another really cute seating area. Oh my gosh, look at this wall. Isn't that wallpaper gorgeous? So you can have breakfast in the morning if you want. So that is where I'm staying.
So good morning, sunshines. It is the next day. Yesterday's festivities did not go as planned. I thought that I would go to some really cool local restaurant and I had a bunch of recs and just kind of sit there and enjoy the atmosphere and have a nice meal to myself. And I got in this bed last night about 6:30. I was feeling a little tired. I started watching some YouTube videos and the next thing I know, I woke up at 2:30 in the morning. So I have to take the non-drowsy Dramamine when I fly because I get a little motion sick when I'm flying. So I only take half of one, like the tiniest little amount. But even though I get the non-drowsy, it just wipes me out. So at 2:30 this morning, I was like, well, I didn't get dinner. I wasn't really hungry, but I ate a little mini Kind bar that I had in my purse and drank some water and then went back to bed. And then I woke up at 6:30, got a shower, got my hair done. I don't have any makeup on and my hair is kind of just how I style it out of the shower. I haven't done any heat products on it or anything. And I'm about to get in an Uber and head to the Wantable warehouse because I can't even believe this is happening, you guys. They are going to do a little photo shoot with me. So I get to get my hair done and my makeup done, and they're gonna have a rolling rack of clothes so we can kind of pick out something that I like. And then I guess there's like a photo studio in their warehouse. So I'm gonna do that, which I think is really fun. I'll try and get some clips of the warehouse because I'm dying to know. So hopefully you guys are too, just a little glimpse of behind the scenes. But that's what's on the agenda today. And then this afternoon, I'm kind of free. I've heard there's a place called the Public Market. So I think I'm gonna have my Uber driver drop me off there, and I think they have like restaurants and shopping maybe. My budget's like really, really tight after taking Dawson to school. You know how you move a kid into the dorm. It's like cha-ching, cha-ching, cha-ching. So anyway, I can't do a lot of shopping, but I could probably get like a cool meal, something like I was hoping to get yesterday, and just kind of hang out. And then tonight is the party, and I'm really, really excited for that too. So come along. Let's see if we can get some sneaky peeks of the Wantable backstage, back warehouse. Yeah, that's what it's called, the warehouse. When I worked for Disney, we always called the back room the backstage, so that's still like in my head. Anyway, we'll see if we can get some little clips of the warehouse and maybe of me getting my hair and makeup done. You can kind of see what the guy does. I just said keep me pretty close to what I look like, but you could do whatever you want. So
I am here in the Wantable warehouse at their photo studio. We're in this little pod, and I'm here with Joseph.
Hi, everyone.
Y'all, Joseph did Mariah Carey's makeup. Don't I look just like her?
Absolutely.
I mean, honestly,
identical.
We're halfway through, and I just want to give you a little update. This pod is so cool. He keeps it like really cold in here, and we're in our own like little area. Like, you can see the warehouse behind you. That's where they do all the photo shoot stuff. Do you want to be? Are you okay?
Sure.
Okay. This is Kristen. She's like my new BFF this weekend. She's head of influencer relations.
Yeah.
I just made her gag. Anyway, I just wanted to give you a little.
I know.
She's like, no, she's not my BFF. Anyway, I just want to give you a little update, and I'll take you around the warehouse in a little bit, if that's okay. Okay, good.
We're gonna do it together. Okay.
Back here, and when I walked in, there was a whole rolling rack of clothes to pick what I wanted to wear for my photo shoot, which is really cool. The whole team was like styling me, and I actually got to keep the outfit that I wore, which you'll see a little bit later when I show you kind of the photo shoot. But when you walk in, Wantable did give me permission to kind of to photograph this. There's a little seating area, and then they've got photo areas back here where they do like the flat lays and where they do their photo shoots. I'll kind of take you back there and I'll kind of show you where everything is. So right now they're doing a shoot. How adorable. Going where the magic happens. We're going back to the Wantable warehouse. I technically think you have to have closed toed shoes to be in here, but they're gonna let me. Oh my goodness. This is where the magic happens. One of you guys has a box in the stack. If you don't, you can use my code for Wantable to get $30 off your very first box. There is a very big conveyor belt back there. Oh my gosh, how cool. So this is where they package everything up if you just want a little behind the scenes. Behind here is where all their samples come in. So all of this stuff is gonna be new for fall. And this is actually where when new items come in, they get it ready to photograph. So if you see a really great piece on the Wantable Instagram or YouTube or wherever, this is where it starts out. So I'll do a little sneaky peek of this. Like, I'm dying to get in here. They have August. They're getting ready to do a denim edit, which I always say Wantable does the best denim because they have different price points and so many different styles than I feel like a lot of the other boxes do. So if you're looking for good denim, when that limited edition box comes out, you may want to grab it and see if you can find a different style. So that's here. And then you can see behind me these little pods. And these, that's where I got my hair and makeup done. And I introduced Joseph on the
on my Instagram stories. I might pull some of those clips in. He actually did Mariah Carey's makeup, and I have to say, I'm loving it. So this was my like glam look. It was a little bit bigger hair. I tucked it behind my ears. And then we're gonna take a little peek. I don't know what's behind here, but I have a feeling it's some of the clothing. So let's go ahead and see what's there. Hang on.
All right, so here's the actual warehouse where all the clothing is. So once your stylist puts together your box, then the people who fill your box will come and grab it. And it's all put together like men's active, sleeve and body. There's women's active over there, and they can just pull from each SKU that your stylist picks for you. This is so interesting to see the behind the scenes, isn't it? I love it.
So I am back. I'm sitting in front of a window, so the lighting might be a little off. Just FYI, through this whole vlog, I'm probably going to be inserting some Instagram footage. So if the screen goes from this to this, you know that's Instagram footage, and then it'll come back out. I'm not used to carrying the camera and capturing all the moments. And so I would take Instagram stories and then not vlog it, or I would vlog it and then not take Instagram stories. So I'm just going to combine everything into this video so you get like a better idea of the behind the scenes, if that's okay. And again, the lighting's probably not going to be great because now I'm sitting in front of a window and earlier I was in a warehouse. But my call time was at 8:50 this morning and I walked into a gorgeous rolling rack full of clothing. It had my name on it. I should have taken a picture, but I forgot. I was overwhelmed, let me just tell you. And so they said, we're going to pick a couple of outfits. We're going to photograph one of them. And so we picked a couple of things. I took them into the bathroom and I really fell in love with this pair of pants that was on the rolling rack. They are orange wide leg pants, which is really not my vibe. Now, when you see this print, you'll know that it's a Kristy print, but I don't know. I wanted to go a little bolder for the camera. I thought it would be fun. So I tried these on first. These are so high-waisted, they almost go up to like my bra, which is so fun. And they look like this. Super wide leg, adorable. I fell in love with these pants. And we tried them on with this little tank top. We tried them on with a couple of shirts, but we tried them on with this tank top, which is tiered, and I was gonna tuck it in. And it looked really, really great. But I thought, you know what? I need a jacket to kind of finish the outfit. And they didn't have anything that we felt like looked great. So then Joseph, who is the hair and makeup guy, and by the way, I had a Zoom call with him later last week, just to talk about like how I wanted my hair and makeup. And I basically said, whatever you decide to do, I'm gonna be really happy with. And so he said, after I got off your Zoom call, I saw this dress and I asked them to pull it for you. He was working with the stylist and they all agreed. So this dress was on the rolling rack. They had everything folded, but I've already pulled it out and looked at it and was so excited. Anyway, this is what the dress looks like. It's a maxi dress in this gorgeous, gorgeous pattern. It's like a tank and it's got a full lining underneath it. And I was like, yeah, I really like that. But I think that they could tell I really liked the pants. And she said, well, you know, we're going to gift you an outfit. So that was kind of the deal, was I got to come and do the photo shoot, which is really, was really for me. And two other influencers got to do it too, the out of town ones. And, they reserve the right to use the photos, but they're really going to me that I can use on social media. And so the deal was they're going to pamper me, do my hair and makeup, do a little photo shoot, and then I got to keep one of the outfits. So the stylist was like, you know, you can keep the orange pants and the white tank, but just do the shoot in the dress. I loved the dress, but I wasn't 100% sold on it at that moment. And I was like, okay, let's do that. And everybody was hyping up the dress. They're like, and I mean, there was a whole rolling rack full of clothes, but this dress fit my body well. The colors looked amazing. It really, they were right. It was the dress to be photographed in. So then I went to hair and makeup. Now that they kind of knew what color I was wearing, so Joseph could do my my lip color, my eye color and everything. So incredibly nice, so down to earth. He let me like ask different, like, what color did you use? What's that? What's that? And so I have like a couple of different MAC lip colors written in my phone. So when I go home next week and I get paid, I'm definitely hitting up the back counter because he had the perfect colors for me. They did my hair. I have some false lashes on, which was really fun too. Everything's like needs to be bigger for camera. And then they took me over to the place we're going to do the photo shoot. And oh my gosh, you guys, I was so nervous because at my heart, I just feel like I'm just a mom. Like, I'm not, I know that I do Instagram and I do YouTube, but I don't feel like I'm a YouTuber. I know I am, but I don't know if you understand what I'm saying, but I just feel like I'm just a mom, you know? I don't know how to pose in front of a camera and do all that. And they had a whole hype team there, like telling me like how to stand, how to move. I got it down pretty quick, I will say. And they would say, walk and do this and do that. And then they were showing me the pictures, like as they were taking them. This dress looks so good. And then they came over and they're like, well, you can wear that dress tonight to the party. And I was like, oh, okay. And then I can give it back to you. And they're like, well, if you picked out the pants, we would have given you the pants, the tank, and the jacket, but we didn't have a jacket. So we're just going to throw in the dress too. So I did get a dress to wear to the party tonight, but I'm totally wearing this one. It's just so, so pretty. I'll take a picture as I'm going to the party. So that was really cool. And then for the photo shoot, they stuck this adorable little clutch in my hand, and I was doing like things with the clutch, and they were like, oh, you can just keep the bag. And then they gave me the earrings too that I wore, so I kind of made out like a bandit. I'm a little bit overwhelmed by their generosity, and they stuck it in a little Wantable box. So that's kind of how the day went, and now I am back. I'm gonna put on just some shorts and a t-shirt. I'm gonna head over to the public market and get some lunch. If I don't see anything over there, Joseph told me there was a place called the Swinging Door, I think it is, that's like right across from the hotel, and he said the food is fabulous. So I'm gonna do that before I come back and get ready for the party tonight. I'm just mind blown at this opportunity that I got to do. I'm so overwhelmed. I feel like I'm holding everything in right now, and I feel like when I get home, I'm probably gonna start crying, just kind of reliving it. Anyway, I'll be back. I'll give you some shots of the public market as I go. And then, of course, I'm going to vlog tonight at the party and show you that too. Thank you. as you can see, I am back and I'm going to recap that last day I was in Milwaukee with Wantable. If you see a movement in the background, Lola is back there kind of hanging out. So when we got to the party, obviously it was a party and people were talking and chatting and milling around, but there was also a band. So I started out trying to vlog, but when I watched the clips back, you really can't hear what I'm saying. And also because of the band, I didn't want this video to get copyright striked. So I just thought I would go ahead and film some clips, put them over music I know was safe, and then I would kind of explain them. So that's what we're gonna do now. If you rewind to the last time I was talking to you, I was leaving to go to the public market. It was only a 2-block walk from the Ken guest house downtown where I was staying, which, by the way, I loved that hotel. It had such a cool, interesting vibe to it. The weather also was perfect when I was in Milwaukee. I kept asking everybody, every Uber driver, every Wantable employee, every waiter or waitress, is the weather always this great? And they were like, no, it's usually much more humid and more hot. But when I was there, it was in like the 70s, low 80s. I mean, no humidity. The weather was perfect. So the public market is very similar to what we have here in Atlanta. What is it called here? The Ponce Market. And then in Nashville, they have something similar. I'm sure a lot of cities do. It's this really great, big, huge space with lots and lots of the cool, hip restaurants all around Milwaukee. So you can get anything from seafood to chocolate to pastries to hummus to pizza to wine and cheese. You just wander through and pick what you want to eat. And then there's a place to sit down. Now, by the time I got there, it was a little bit later on Friday afternoon. I think the tourists were starting to come in. I think people were getting off of work and coming in, and it was really kind of crowded. And I didn't want to sit. I don't like to sit and eat when like there's people all around. Now, there was a top floor and nobody was eating up there, so I could have gone up there. But I just took some pictures and then left, because as I was walking to the public market, I saw a restaurant I had seen when I was kind of researching restaurants in the area called Tupelo Honey. And I had my heart set on eating there. So Tupelo Honey is a restaurant that does Southern fare. And I thought, I'm a Southern girl. Let's see how the Midwest does it. Holy cow, knocked my socks off. I am not kidding you. I got the best shrimp and grits I have ever had in my entire life. I am a grits aficionado. I know not everybody likes grits, but I love them. And it's hard to make a grit that's Kristy approved. It was so incredibly good. And then I took a little mini banana pudding back with me to the hotel while I went to get ready for the party. But can't say enough about Tupelo Honey. You got to see the public market. Now, that whole area is called the Third Ward, and there's tons of like shops and things. I really didn't have time to do that. But I got to tell you, I've emailed all of my girlfriends. I've told my husband. I've told my kids. I'm like, I love Milwaukee. And I am not kidding. I fell in love with Milwaukee. Who knew? You guys, I'm sure you did, but I did not know. And I really want to go back there and spend some more time being a tourist, because I just thought it was really, really great. But after I ate at Tupelo Honey, I went back to the hotel. It's almost like catty-cornered from our hotel. And I had to get ready. My makeup was already pretty much done, and so was my hair from the photo shoot that morning. But when I got back, my mascara had kind of run all over my eyelids, so I had to take the gorgeous eye makeup that Joseph did off and kind of redo it. I didn't do it anywhere near as well as he did, but I was able to save the lashes and they stayed on my face, which is good. Kind of fluffed up my hair, and then I went downstairs. Now, when I went downstairs, I saw the other two out-of-town influencers, Laura, who you guys have been asking me all over social media if I saw, from Little Box of Happy. Yes, I did see her, and you probably saw her in the clips that just played. She was there with her husband. They were kind of having a little getaway. And then Liesl, who I didn't know, she's an influencer from Nashville. And I know Laura was waiting on their car, and so I said to Liesl, hey, do you want to ride together? She'd already called the Uber, and she said yes. Now, I have to say, when I got in the car with Liesl, it was like meeting an old friend, only you're just meeting this person for the first time. I don't even know if that makes sense, but we just like clicked. She is younger than me. She's like in her early 30s. She has a little cutie son who, I gotta tell you, made my ovaries hurt when I saw pictures of him. So So cute, but we just hit it off immediately. There was no awkwardness in the conversation. It was really, really cool. And we got to the event and kind of walked around just a little bit, but I had an appointment at 6:50 to do something called bonded bracelet. So they were on a very strict schedule. And apparently this is like a hot thing in Milwaukee. When I went to the lunch with the influencers the day before, they were like, oh my gosh, we're so excited they're coming. Several of the girls had them. And then Liesl told me that it was a big thing in Nashville. So I got online and I was like, does this happen in Atlanta? And it does. I don't think it's as popular here, but it's starting to be. And so I'm definitely going to get more. But the concept of it is you go up to the booth and she has these huge spools, think like rope or thread or something, full of gold and silver change. And I mean, this is real gold. And they measure it out. She fits it to your wrist, make sure that you've got enough movement and you like where it is. And then she literally bonds it to itself, the two ends, like takes a little welder. You see the little spark, I think, in the clip, and it's on, it's permanent. There's no clip on here to take it off. It just stays. And it's so dainty. I picked a really, really small little dainty one and so perfect. I'm not a huge bracelet girl. I do like beaded, like stretchy bracelets, but I want them off as soon as I get home. This is perfect. I've been swimming in it since I've got home. I've taken a shower in it, and I definitely want a couple of more. So the one place I saw that does it does go travels around and does like pop-ups. So I'm going to follow her and make sure that I can get more because it was really, really cool. By that time, Laura got there with her husband and she was a little frantic. What we didn't know was she was having trouble getting the valet to find their car when we left her at the hotel. I guess he got there and he's like, I can't find your car. And she was like, I gotta be somewhere. She was worried that she was late. I felt so horrible because I just assumed like they're waiting for their car, which they were, but she could have easily just jumped in the Uber with us. But she got there and she was fine and everything was great. But I just feel like never assume, you know what I mean? And so we kind of hung out for a little while and then we all sort of went our separate ways. Before that happened though, I will say when Liesl and I got there, we saw a food truck that was loaded tater tots. And that's all we wanted. We had to go get our bracelets first, but then we made a beeline over to that truck. It had like tater tots mushed up with either spinach artichoke or pulled pork or Nashville hot chicken. And they were like deep fried into balls. Holy cow, were those good. I had the spinach artichoke dip and then I traded with another Wantable employee because we each wanted to try the other. And I tried the pulled pork and I thought that one was really great. I didn't try the Nashville hot chicken, but really, really good. So after we ate, we kind of separated out. I don't think I've ever shared this with you guys, not because I was trying to hide anything, but because it really didn't have anything to do with the YouTube channel. But I'd worked with Wantable a few times in the past, I think about a year and a half ago. They had like a stylist appreciation luncheon and they asked me if I would zoom in with some other people and like talk to the stylist, which I was so happy to do. And then when they started their affiliate program, I think I was one of the influencers that helped. They like started helping to pilot it. I had worked with a lot of the Wantable people behind the scenes and it was so cool to put names with faces. Some people I didn't recognize immediately, they would recognize me, and then when they introduce themselves, I'm like, oh my gosh, you've styled my box before, or I don't know. It was really, really cool to just meet the people behind the scenes. And I have to say, if you're looking for a job in Milwaukee, check out Wantable, because every single person that I talked about the culture of the company and how great it was, like how much they bust their butts, but how much they're willing to stop and help each other without it being like this backbiting experience you see in other companies. And you could genuinely tell that that was true. Whether I was at the luncheon or the photo shoot or and seeing the people packing the boxes, like I saw everything firsthand and it just felt so warm and inviting. And every single person that I talked to was so cool. I made a friend in the drink line. It was like one of the executives' sister, I think, and we just bonded and talked. So it was just a fun, like easy night. They had a ton of food trucks. Like I said, the stuffed tater tot truck was really good. They had a gourmet like brick oven pizza truck that made like pizza with peaches. One pizza had hot honey on it. I forgot to try that one. I'm kicking myself. And a couple others, they had a tostada truck. They had stuffed mushrooms. They had this whole bar of like gourmet cookies. They had a cotton candy machine, and this lady was doing like gourmet flavors. I got mango with like sparkles on it. It was so yummy. They had tons of like photo opportunities. Oh, I had never seen this before, but if you're looking for a cool party idea, you're hosting a party, they made these charcuterie cones. I'm sure they were catered, but they were cones with charcuterie like in like long sticks in them. And then they had like happy birthday pics. They look so good. I forgot to get one. Y'all, I was running my mouth. So I didn't actually eat a lot while I was there. They had custom like themed drinks, and I'm not a big drinker. I only drink like once or twice a year maybe, but I got something called the Incredimule. I believe it was vodka, ginger beer, which I'm not a beer girl, and watermelon. I think it had something else in it. Y'all, I sucked that down faster than I care to admit. And I was like, I cannot have any more. Even though I was Ubering back, I just wanted to have my wits about me. And the party took place in the Wantable Cafe, which is really cool because they have these big garage doors they could open. And it was just a lovely, beautiful night. Like I said, they had a photo booth, tons of like photo opportunities throughout the party. And I don't know, it was just a lovely time. So if you saw the picture of me with two other girls on the swing, that is Little Box of Happy. In case you don't know, she has a YouTube channel. Her name is Laura. And then obviously there was Liesl also. And so we got a picture of the three of us together. And then there's another picture that you see in front of a wooden wall. And that picture has Kristen in it. And Kristen is the head of influencer relations over at Wantable. I've never seen anybody work so hard in my entire life. She was keeping everything on track and doing the best job. As a matter of fact, I just felt like her mama, because every like hour I'd come over and say, do you need water? Do you need something? Because she was so focused on making sure everybody else had a good time that I wanted to make sure she was having a good time. Anyway, about 9:15 or so, we all kind of came together and decided we wanted to take some pictures together. And then we were about ready to leave. So Laura and her husband said, hey, we have the rental car. Do you just want to ride home with us? Which was so incredibly nice. So we took a few pictures and then we headed back to the hotel. You guys, I had had the false lashes on since about 9:30 that morning. And it was about probably by the time we got to the hotel, probably like 9:45 or 10. So a solid 12 hours. And all I wanted was to take those false lashes off. As we were getting out of the car, I was ripping those babies off. So we all went back to our hotel, kind of went to our prospective rooms. I washed my face, took a shower, got in the bed, started watching some Netflix, and just kind of sat there and let myself be in my emotions about the incredible weekend. I felt like a princess. And it's not lost on me that you guys are the reason that I got to go. I'm not downplaying the work that I've done. I work really hard behind the scenes. And I pump out a lot of content. But if you guys weren't here to watch my videos, if you weren't here to click on my links, this trip would not have happened. I'm so grateful. If you hear nothing else, thank you. So grateful to each of you for doing that. I have the best subscribers, I really and truly do. Sorry, I'm not an emotional person, but I want you to know that I'm truly, truly grateful. And truly thank you to Wantable for this amazing experience. I just never thought something like this could ever happen. And it really was magical. They made me feel so special. So thank you, Wantable. I also want to say, if you're watching this and you haven't hit the subscribe button, please go ahead and hit that subscribe button. If you want to try Wantable, they have so many good boxes, from a sleep and body edit to an active edit to a fashion edit to themed boxes every month. I have a discount code to get $30 off your first box at checkout. So definitely go check out Wantable, and I'll be back soon with another video, but definitely go check out Laura's channel. She's also on Instagram, and Liesl's on Instagram, but I think she has a YouTube channel too. I'll put their information down below. I think you're really gonna like both of them. And yeah, I'll see you soon for another video, guys. Thank you again. Bye-bye.